Halfway. Step in.
Yep. And I come down, I'm switching, driving back up. I want to focus on lifting from here, not getting the ground up. Work. Fuck. Good. Why do I need to? All I gotta do is control the top half, my hips going with me.
But everything we've been doing, we ain't been reaching. So why when I start to run, why am I reaching? This is what I told you.
You're going up?
We're gonna go back here.
No, I'm saying I feel like because I was going up.
Yeah.
That's why I was reaching.
So I don't need to reach with my feet, I just need to pick my hips up. Because that's what I was doing down there. Everything I was doing, I was operating through the hips. So now when I come to competition, why am I changing how when I was warming up? You feel what I'm saying? That's what I just told you about. When I get in game, I'm trying to do something different, but I ain't see that when I was warming up. Why am I doing that? I'm creating my own chaos.
Facts.
Yeah.
So we were just talking about that 3 days ago. That's how you get hurt.
Yeah, we just said it right there.
Yeah.
Hear the buzzer again. No. It's here. Sink them here. Get in your ready position.
Pick up. I don't need to fight to bring that ball here. I'm trying to flow, right? I'm not about to get tackled, right? So I want to create rhythm. Yep, but it needs to be here.
Here. We activate like that. It allows me to cycle.
So when you wake that up and keep it in motion, I'm smooth. It naturally pulls me to where I'm trying to go. Yeah. That's why I got that's why I got a weak visa.
Yeah, but we already been doing that.
Yeah.
So now I shouldn't be trying to make my feet work harder.
Yeah. Facts.
Work.
Come on. Stay connected to the floor.
Connection.
Low.
I gotta get my motor going from the ground, when my heels should naturally already be peeling. So when I drive, it's thighs.
Yeah. And then when I climb up the step, it's just me.
Stay low. Pick the chest up. Knee. There we go. Get one more in. Stay low. Peel the heels off the ground. Hold up. Hey, we're not bottling ourselves up. Space. Drive. One more. Now, the only thing I want you to do, right? When I give you that clap, react from here and maintain that reaction around there, all right? Your first three steps should be all, all right?
here, I create more connection from my big toe going up that mountain, right? But I have to, even though my shoes are forcing me to do this, I mentally have to fight to create space so I can wake up everything in there. You feel me?
Yeah.
Last one, you climb it all the way up. By the time I get to my second orange cone, I should be at my rim. Now I just gotta maintain that all the way up the steps. I shouldn't be trying to create a different cycle. I'm not trying to fight myself, I'm just trying to stay consistent with what I have. So when I take off, it is. I don't want to pause. Matter of fact, yeah.
Into the balls of your feet. Sit, sit, sit.
back in that box position. Think like you are, you gotta take a step, right? If I gotta take that step, I'm not gonna move just with my foot. My hip is gonna put me in place now because I'm creating that distance from the guard or the tackle. So I want my hips to shoot me. No. You see how you go from hip in the front and his foot on the floor? Bring both of your hips forward.
Oh.
Yeah. No. But I can't, if this leg is going up, this leg can't be going down. This one needs to be lifting too, but I need to be lifting through the hips. Climb. Lift. All the way to the top, all the way to the top. Hips. Step up. Keep your elbows away from your body. Away, like a way out in front. Bend the bend. Bend. Come on. Now, you see how I'm still trying to flex from here. Put the bar out. Rotate. It's like you're twisting a jaw. You see how the bar is not moving? The bar should be moving because I'm rotating through
my hand.
Yeah. When I rotate through the shoulder, everything moves. You see how it's not moving? Bring your shoulder up. Straighten out. Pull. Don't lean back. Pull. Yep. Now flatten. Drop the arms just a little bit. And as you drop, squeeze from armpits and elbows. Now, your hands and wrists got to be connected with that bitch. I got to move all as one. So I got to get in more engagement through my pinky. Squeeze. Keep going. Now, try to pull your elbows back. Keep pulling. And that bar should be bending more right there. Armpits, elbow. Yeah, yep. Now squeeze more. Yep. Draw in, pick up here. Don't lean back, lean forward. There you go. The same way I go up is the same way I go down. So I'm reaching with that foot. But you felt it. A lot more connection, correct? Yeah, but that's because I'm not
letting my hands restrict.
Once I go, I can't be too slow and let my legs die. I gotta snap it back up and down. Yeah. Don't let your feet get stuck in the mud. then my cycle is just gonna put me
right there to where now I just gotta lift through my thighs and not so much reaching for my feet. You feel me? Because if I'm going up the steps, my hips are already close. Take it back. Is it? All right, we're not gonna put it on 45. Scroll down. One.
As we go through our quarters, we shouldn't be fading in our workout if we really are putting that work in, day out. Game time, by the time I get to that hour of the game, last four quarter, whatever, I should be at my peak because that's our conditioning period. You feel what I'm saying? And that's really not even conditioning because we ain't did nearly as enough work on this game as I do during practice. I'm at about 200 reps at practice. Come game, I'm only getting like 60, 70 plays.
So you shouldn't be gassed.
Yeah, I'm 200 reps a day.